I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. Okay, today we're going to talk about time and how valuable it is, but also talking about where the hell have I been in the last X amount of months. So I haven't been on YouTube making consistent content for about 4 to 5 months. I gave you a few videos with a few like incoherent things saying, please subscribe to this other channel. I can't give you any context, but please do. And you did, but thank you. Can't tell you what it is for yet. Still in the progress. So apart from all of those, I haven't been making video consistently for about 4 or 5 months. So where have I been and what have I been doing? Well, since September of last year and June of this year, I was making consistent content every other day, every single other day. And on Patreon, I was filling in those every other day gaps with content. So essentially, I was making a video every single day for about 10 months. And then in that time, I realized that I was able to do that at the same time as holding a job. So why am I putting all of this time in doing my job in retail when I can do this and something else instead of doing that job? I quit April of this year. I quit my job in retail, and I've been working in retail for about 7 years. I think it was just shy of 7 years I was working for this specific company. And even though I've got a really good relationship with that company, I come to understand that I quit my job in retail because I was valuing my time more and more as time went on. But let me explain what I mean, because that doesn't really make sense if you're not in my head. Time is the most valuable currency that you have because it's the only thing you can give and it's limited. I can only give you my time. So when you think that you work in retail and you spend 30 hours a week and you get £250, for example, in return for your time, then you're giving yourself a number on how valuable your time is. Not to mention that even though you work 30 hours a week, it could take you an hour a day for getting there and back from your job. You need to think about time you need to wake up before you need to go to work. So that number 30 hours a week can really easily go up to 40 or 45 hours a week when you consider all the other factors. So that time that you're spending, or the time that I was spending, let's say 45 hours a week from all the other bits and pieces, and I was still able to make consistent content on the internet, I was thinking about the time I was spending on that versus the time that I could be spending that 45 hours a week doing, the relationship isn't great. So when you disassociate the relationship between your time and the amount of money that you get, and you come to realize that your time is more valuable and the experience that you have is more valuable than that, then that's when you kind of realize, I don't want to be in retail. Why am I here? Yes, the money is consistent. Yes, the money can be good, but no, the time you spend doing that isn't great. I decided to pursue YouTube as a full-time career after April, because that's when I quit my job. However, as we all know, YouTube, although it's a good platform, especially for me, I particularly enjoy the platform of YouTube, it's not really consistent with money specifically, but with audience engagement, with YouTube getting your videos into the recommended sections, things like that. It's very difficult. There's loads and loads of people on YouTube now, and it makes it increasingly more challenging. Patreon is a good platform because it is very consistent. The money that I've been making on Patreon has been more consistent than the money that I've been making on YouTube. Maybe it's not more money on Patreon than the more money that I make on YouTube, but it's more consistent. So YouTube, although it's good for me, it's not really dependable. So I was thinking about what I could do in order to use my time more effectively in the field of videos. And I decided that I've been on YouTube for over 10 years, over 11 years now. So I know the ins and outs of YouTube stuff quite well. Although my subscriber count doesn't show that, I think that I've been doing particularly well for the skills, for the content, the type of content that I make. I've done particularly well. There's a giant wasp right outside my window. And I'm also getting handier and handier with cameras as my funds increased and the amount of money that I had to put into it. My investment into my own channel has increased, and I've been using DSLR cameras and fancy microphones and tripods, and I got this the other day, which is a DJI Ronin S for the thing that I'm about to tell you in a minute. So I used that to my advantage. So I'm a freelance videographer and I'm a freelance YouTube consultant, which is a title that I think I made up, but yet to be seen. So what that means, like, let's go for videography. So what I've been doing in my time since I've been away is that I've been building a business in which I am a freelance videographer. So I find an event that somebody's willing to pay me to film. I go and film that event, I edit the video, and I give them back the video to them. And then I get paid for that. I just go try and do different events. However, my niche is quite nichey because I have so much experience on YouTube that I know and understand the platform particularly well. So there's this one particular company that I've been working with quite closely in which I am their YouTube consultant. So I made content plan, I go and film it, I edit it, I come back, I post it on their channel because I'm a manager of the channel, and I do all the metadata, the titles, the tagging, the description, the thumbnail, all of that stuff. And I do that consistently and I post content on their channel. That's what I've been doing. At this current time, right now, I'm living at my brother's house just temporarily so that I can build up my income stream and build up my business and build up the YouTube channel so that I can live somewhere else. I go and move house and move in with the woman. Yes, the woman and I are still together. The goal that I had last year was in April, I wanted to quit retail for a whole year. So if I can make it to April doing the things that I'm doing, then I think that's particularly good because a lot of businesses fail within the first year. And if I can make that, then I at least think that I've done well-ish. So one of the things that I need to do for the end of this year and the start of next year is to fully discover the relationship between time and money and try and find a good balance between the time I spend doing things and the amount of money that I get. And one of the things that I wanted to do with that is to work smarter, not harder. We go back to that example of 45 hours a week in which you have spend your time getting £250 from retail work and you use that to something else in which you don't have to spend any time doing that and you still get the good money for it, then that's what I want. And the way that I've figured this out is a product. I know it's simple idea that most businesses have, but create a product. For me, it would be a lucid dreaming product in which I create an online course. So I've been writing a series of Word documents or Google documents in which I've been, over the last couple weeks and couple months, been slowly building towards making a video course. A highly detailed how to lucid dream series in which I start with a beginner version and then I work my way up to an intermediate version of how to lucid dream. Then what I'd do is I'd redo my website and I'll post it on there and people can buy from there. They don't have to if they don't want to, but that's the sweetness of a product. So this will solidify the relationship between time and money. So I spend so much time creating this bit of content for my website that once I've done it, I don't have to worry about creating the video anymore. I don't have to worry about anything else apart from advertising that thing. That's all I have to do. And if I can do that, if I do that, that adds another revenue stream which puts it into this channel, which allows me to do something else and then get that revenue and put it in. And I'm just trying to slowly build a business. That's pretty much what I've been trying to do. And that's where I've been over the last 5 months. Occasionally I've been streaming and occasionally I do post a video every now and then, but I think with this consistent content that I'm doing at the moment, in which I'm posting a video every single day for however long I need to, every single day, I think this is gonna work well. It will drive me and focus my attention to something so that I can continue doing something else. So that's that for this video. Thank you very much for all your support. Thank you to the Patreon supporters, like I said earlier. If you wanna be a supporter of the Patreon page, link in the description box below. You can also be a member. If you click that join button right underneath this video, then I think it's $4.99 a month and you get a few perks there as well. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see you tomorrow when it's gonna be a lucid dreaming content. I'll see you tomorrow in which we are going to discuss how to master lucid dreaming. Until then,